he is becoming the greatest president that we have ever had, though, because to me, he is an American nationalist, and he is also a patriot.
It goes into the culture war that we're fighting and what we're trying to fight on. It feels like the intelligentsia or the chattering class of America no longer believes in this idea of American exceptionalism, or that we
law and order, war on drugs. All these are dog whistle terms that they use to appeal to each other to go, this is what we're going to do to minorities. This is what we're going to do. This is the way we're going to try to drive this ship a little bit. Patriot's the new one.
Ain't nothing but in mind. Well, I want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me. Just whatever soul I've got. I want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me. Tell the word is the soul of a man.
Everybody has their own little subjective definition of what patriotism is. Is that taking pride in this country, honoring the flag since so many men. Men and women had actually died for your rights, for your American rights, had died so that you can be entitled to the Constitution, and have died to keep you alive today. It also represents, you know, the police, the military, who really want to defend us. We have the greatest, most powerful military in the world.
My job as a patriot is to make sure that America is who they say they are, who we say we are, because I gave 5 years of my youth to this country. And I know a lot of people who did not, who look at me as if I'm lesser of a person. What did you do for your country? You're saying, go back to where you came from. This is my country. What did you give for your country? Did you give as much as these trans service members? Did you give as much as these black service members, these Muslim service members, these Sikh service members?
Yeah.
Right?
I define patriotism as someone who is willing to stand up for their fellow Americans. That's less about a flag or nationalism and more about communities and neighborhoods. Whether or not someone puts up an American flag for me is not indicative of whether they're a patriot. And in some ways, unfortunately, today, the flag has come to mean that people are Trump supporters or that they're America firsters. And instead, what I want us to be focusing on, and really what patriotism means to me, is that I am willing to work hard, put my body on the line, and do what I can to protect my neighbors and friends from civil rights violations committed by other people, including white supremacists and Nazis, and people who work at government institutions.
I do not define a patriot as something better than. And I say that because one of the things that I've gleaned from how that word's being thrown around, patriot, is like the U.S. is better than here. You know, U.S. is better than Iran. U.S. is better than Canada. U.S. is better than Mexico.
It's the idea of, you know, being unapologetic about American exceptionalism, about American values, about American culture, Western civilization. I mean, there's so many things it feels like, you know, yeah, and this goes into the culture war that we're fighting and what we're trying to fight on. It feels like the intelligentsia or the chattering class of America no longer believes in this idea of American exceptionalism, or that we actually have this, you know, this is an incredible country with so much to offer. America is great because of her people, and we need to really start having pride. There's this idea that having American pride no longer is something that is acceptable. And that's really what it means for me, is being unapologetic about being proud about being American.
So for me, I run Patriot Prayer, and I'm Jesus-centered. I follow Jesus. Okay. And Jesus doesn't care about what your skin color is. He doesn't care about the labels the world puts on you. He cares about the way that he made you, the way that God made you. Okay. And Nazis are going to dislike someone because of their genetic background. That's called ignorance, and that's stupidity. And so I'm totally against that. And it's just another form of hate, which I'm against all forms of hate.
Tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a man. gotta want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me. Say the word is the soul of a man. I read the Bible often. I try to read it right. And for as I go.
When they say we're going to make America great again, we need to go back to when America was great. When?
Like, we can't go back to the 1950s. We can't go back. Do you have this idea of a golden age?
1950. Okay, let's go back to 1950. It was great for you. Who was it not great for? Black people, Mexicans, gays, trans, women, who were still getting lobotomized if they had any type of sexual drive.
And the world we live in at any particular time is a product of so many factors. The factors that were extant, you know, in this golden age of America no longer really exist.
Bring back a lot of the great things that the country once had. Now, during that time, was like I said, was there a lot of, like, not so positive things that happened, such as Jim Crow? Yes, that wasn't great at all. But there was still a lot of great things about, you know, like the family unit, and the family unit was really great at that time, especially for the Black community.
Well, it's a great slogan. That's another example of why, you know, his branding ability. Trump is an entrepreneur and a businessman.
He is the anti-everything when it comes to what America is supposed to be. But it's all in the name of white superiority, so they'll ride that train till it crashes.
Tell me, answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a. Gotta want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a man.
I was so proud the day when they signed into law that you could serve openly in the military across the board, and transgenders, people were allowed to serve, LGBT were allowed to serve. And I remember thinking back of when I was in, when I didn't have that right, I didn't have that at all. So I say that because when I heard that he was rolling that back, and who knows what else he may roll back as it relates to the military. He may try to go back and gay serving openly, maybe roll back. I was just, quite frankly, damn mad. Like, so mad, so hurt, so traumatized.
It's not so much a trans ban, it's more of a medical transition ban. I mean, the reality is, you can't tell by looking at someone. Before I transitioned, you couldn't tell by looking at me that I was trans, because it was just like a normal person, normal, you know, guys. Just, there's nothing about you that looks obvious. So those people, like, if you don't transition, there's trans people that are in the closet right now that have not medically transitioned in the military, and no one will ever know unless they say anything.
Trump is using a tactic that has been used for as long as we have literature. Every atrocity that you can point to, it always starts with that figure dehumanizing a particular group of people, whatever.
I hate to say this, but there are lots of problems with the trans community, and the question is the juice worth the squeeze?
Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a. Gotta want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me.
Our country's president condemned violence on both sides, but an objective viewer of what happened in Charlottesville, and unfortunately what's happening across the country right now, is not that there is violence on both sides. It's that there are Nazis, Confederate romantics, and white supremacists who are coming out and targeting communities of color and others to make them feel unsafe.
And I've seen interviews of white supremacists that say, like, I'll die before I lose my position. And they mean that. They're willing to die. Like, they would rather die than be the minority. Because their fear is, if we're the minority, we will be treated the way we treated minorities for forever.
I mean, to be honest, I don't really like, you know, that segment in the white population that feels like guilty for being white, though. You should not have to feel any kind of like white guilt or be some kind of like white apologist.
That dangerous thing that Trump uses and people like him and the alt-right, they fall into it. It goes back to what I mentioned before about dehumanizing. And what I don't like is that they're using that word to create an us-them environment and trying to give, in my opinion, patriotism a new definition that it's not.
Tell me, answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a. Gotta want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me.
Just being black in a car is probable cause from the search or shit, just in case you didn't know.
People will then argue and will say that, well, there's evidence out there that black men are more likely to be brutalized at the hands of police than white men or Hispanic men. Well, I have to kind of throw it out there after, you know, like I said, stepping out of my bubble. I found out that black men are just more likely to resist arrest, though.
White boys talk reckless to police officers, reckless. Can be belligerent, can be high off whatever, or reckless. And they'll still do everything in their power before they put him down, right? They might tase him, they might beat him up, but first they'll talk to him like a normal human. They might talk to him like a child, like, hey, it's okay, Jerry, it's okay. We got a call from the neighbors, it's okay, right? Yeah. That'd be nice. That'd be a beautiful way to every law enforcement incident I've ever had, which I was never involved in anything. I was at the wrong place at the wrong time. I was the wrong race at the wrong time.
Like, I think like less than 1% or maybe 1% of police officers are bad. Because yes, you have some really bad, crooked cops out there. Just like how you have bad teachers, bad doctors, because I think there are like thousands and thousands of cases where a medical mistake was made and that nearly cost a person's life in the hospital, or did cost a person's life in the hospital, but we're not over here claiming doctor brutality.
With Donald Trump at the reins, I don't know if this will happen, but again, I didn't think he was going to win either, so I can't put anything past him. But we're talking him signing bills to where it doesn't restrict the type of equipment that the police get, where they get like military equipment now.
Yeah.
Military, like we're talking police, the same police who do what they want to with black people.
Yeah.
Now have military grade weapons.
If today the police can beat me up or kill me without any consequences, tomorrow they can do it to someone else. When I think of what it means to be an American, I think about the ongoing struggle to realize the values that we say we have. It's not fair or accurate to say that everyone enjoys equal protections right now, or that everyone is safe right now. That's something that we're working towards.
Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a. Gotta want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me. Tell me what is the soul of a man.
Like, I don't really like the race hustlers and the race pimps such as the Al Sharptons and the Maxine Waters, because they're only just in it for themselves, though.
That's my type of patriotism, where it's like everybody deserves a fair shake. Colin Kaepernick, no, I didn't take offense to that at all.
No.
And every veteran, and I don't say that dramatically, every single veteran that I know personally has zero problem with it.
Mr. Al Sharpton, Reverend Sharpton, whatever you guys want to call him, he is trying to racialize the whole NFL issue when Trump, you know, said that, hey, all of those SOBs need to be fired because they are disgraced. They're a disgrace to the American people and to the American flag that they are disrespecting. And so Sharpton tried to make it seem like he was attacking black men, since the NFL is 70% black men.
I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a gotta want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a man.
If you could tell all the non-black people in the world something just about what it's like to be a black American male, like, what would you say?
Oh, God, I don't know. You got enough,
I got some juice in here. Yeah, we're good. We're good.
We couldn't change our skin, so how can we walk into a room? We tell ourselves, how do we learn how to walk into a room if we're all surrounded with Caucasians to make them feel comfortable? So they don't feel threatened. You know, I was a big, tall black man. And I didn't want them to think I was going to be like, you know. So I learned that's not what they like. They don't like that. They like a nice, quiet, smiles.
That's how I'm talking now. It's usually how I talk. But, yeah, you know, so if I were to talk like this, or came in like this, with, like, all these fucking cameras and shit, and this mic shit, and that kind of way, right? Be a different vibe, be a different feeling, right?
My features, the way I speak, the texture of my hair, my tattoos, my everything, my size, that's a big black guy. In the military, I was the big angry black guy who spoke up for himself.
Right.
Right, so.
Why were you labeled angry? What made them think that you were angry?
Because I was angry.
Okay.
I was angry at the racist comments. I was angry at some song come on, he was like, hey, come on, I know you know how to do this dance. And I'm like, no. But they go, hey, I'm going to Popeye's. You want some? You want me to get you some fried chicken and some grape soda? I'm like, who are you talking to?
We don't want to hurt you. Really, we don't want any problems. Like, how you don't want problems, like, when you leave your house, you want to get in your car and go do your little errands and maybe go to work and, you know, come home to your kids. We want the same shit. Like, it's just playing the cards you were dealt, you know, in society's rules, our card is... We don't even have a hand, okay? We weren't given a hand. We had to take a hand. We had to find a hand.
I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a gotta want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a man.
The DNA ancestry test, and I got like 65%, you know, African and 35% European. And since, you know, that's generally speaking how people have viewed me, like, you know, most people have viewed me my entire life, I would just say that, yeah, I would identify with the mixed race label.
You can be mixed, but you don't get to just walk around and go, I'm multiracial, I'm mixed, I don't identify with anything. Society is going to identify you one way or another. It's just the way people, humans are. Humans have to have boxes because it makes our lives easier.
So, like, you know, like in Berkeley, I mean, I was taught that, you know, African Americans are victims. It's the white man's fault that black people are in the position that they're in. And I believe that for, like, my entire life, especially since, yeah, my mom, you know, used to talk to me about, you know, those kinds of things and police officers and, you know, police brutality.
My mother is all the way white.
Okay.
My mother, strawberry blonde hair, blue eyes.
Okay.
The whole side of my family is white.
Okay.
But I have never been mistaken for white in my life. But I have always been, to my core, a black man.
Yeah.
Not because I one day just decided, like, I'm black. Because at some point, society decided for me, you're black. My interactions with police were always...
Like a black man.
Like a black man's.
Right.
When I got arrested, my profile said 6'4", 200-something pounds, black man.
Yeah.
It didn't say multiracial, maybe he's white, maybe it was black man.
Yeah.
I got arrested as a black man. I got put in jail as a black man. That's who I was. In jail was a black man.
Economy in the community isn't really great and everything. But I'd like to still ask, is that what presents a greater danger to the black community, the breakdown of the family, absentee fathers, or the police? It's a breakdown of the family and absentee fathers, because even Obama said that, hey, I mean, if you grow up without a father, you're 5 times more likely to go down the wrong path in life. And since 72% of black children are born to like unwed mothers and don't have a father in their life, the kids are gonna more likely turn to a life of crime though. Like, I didn't have my dad in my life at all though, but I was still fortunate not to turn to a life of crime like that though. But did the white man tell my dad to abandon me?
I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a gotta want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me just what is the soul of a man.
I did vote for him, but I'm here to wait to see. I want to see results.
Okay.
The next people ask me, do I support him? Do I support him? I was like, well, I'll tell you in 2020, because I don't worship politicians. I want to see results. Okay, I want to see more jobs. I want to see lower taxes, less regulations. If the rich gets richer, like it has in the last 20 years, and the poor gets poorer, then I'm going to be pissed.
The work that I do at CARE is centered around the U.S. Constitution. Day in and day out, I am advocating for constitutional protections for members of my community as well as my fellow Americans. It is indeed how I live out my patriotism.
An American, I mean, even though am I also African descent? Yes, but I'm an American first, and then I'm black and white and whatever is composed in my ethnic gene pool.
I'm not African or bloodline descent. I wasn't born in Africa. A white person born in Africa can come to America and get citizenship, and that dual citizenship would make them African-American.
So you're not African-American?
I'm not African-American. I don't know what the fuck I am. Can I say fuck? Is that okay?
What I was raised to believe is we are Americans now. Forget it. We don't subscribe to the whole thing. We just need to pick up and go back to Africa kind of. We're here. We're here now. We're Americans. This is our country. Oh, we helped build this damn country. It's ours, and we're part of it. And yes, I'm a patriot, because this is my country.
You don't necessarily have to give 5 years of military service, but you have to give something. Because that's the definition of patriotism, too. If you want something from this country, you got to give to this country. I mean, John F. Kennedy was like, ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. That's the idea of a patriot.
you love your country, you can be a patriot. That's you are a patriot if you love your country. But my love isn't unconditional when it comes to this country. I don't have unconditional love for a country who doesn't have unconditional love for everybody.